Hello everyone, this is Preeti Yadav. So today I am going to explain you chapter number 7 of 3rd class English literature. The chapter name is Five Little Brothers. So first of all, I want to tell you who is the poetess of this poem. So everyone, Ella Wheeler Wilcox was the poetess of this poem, and she was the greatest poet and at her time. And Ella wrote many poems in her early age, and that was a very easy to understood to the people and students. Okay everyone, Five Little Brothers is a very cute little poem, and in this poem the poetess used a metaphor between five little brothers and five little toes. So that in this chapter we will see about who were the five little brothers and who were the five little toes. Okay everyone, so let's start now everyone. But first of all, I want to ask you this, tell me how you will feel that if you were to stay in a room for an entire day. Obviously, if you will be stay in an entire day in a gloomy room, so you will be feel very dull, very anxious, and you want to be get to be outside of that room. So everyone, in this poem I will tell you what was happened with the five little brothers. So everyone, first of all, I want to read this full poem, so please listen very carefully. Five little brothers set out together to the journey the livelong day. In a curious carriage all made of leather, they hurried away. One big brother and they're quite small, and one wee fellow no size at all. The carriage was dark and none too roomy, they could not move about. The five little brothers grew very gloomy, and their wee one fellow to pout, till the biggest one whispered, "What do you say? Let's leave the carriage and run away." So out they scampered, the five together, and off the away and spat. When somebody found the carriage of leather, of my, how she shook her head, toes, her little boy shoes, as everyone knows, and five little brothers were five little toes. So everyone, let's start now. Five little brothers set out together to the journey livelong day. Means in this stanza, the poet wants to say that there are five little brothers. They plan to set out together, go outside, okay, for the all day long, okay, in a curious carriage all made of leather. And there was a curious carriage, there was a van, there was a car, and it was made by the leather. And they hurried away, and they came hurry, and they set into the curious carriage. Means the curious carriage is compared with the shoes here, and the five little brothers compared with the five little toes. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there are five little brothers compared, use means we can say that a metaphor, compared with the five little brothers, five little toes, and the curious carriage made was compared, which is compared with the shoes. It was made with the leather. So everyone, see, one big brother and their three quite small, and the one wee fellow at no size at all. Means in this, there were five little brothers, so there in that, there was a one elder brother, and their three was very quite small, when they were very small. And one wee fellow, what is a wee fellow? Wee fellow meaning is very small. And there was a very small brother, that any there is no size of him. Means there were a five little brothers, one big was very elder, and three were very quite small, and there was one and it was not having its size, and it was very small. So the carriage was dark and none too roomy, and they could not move about. Means as they set out into the curious carriage, and the curious was not so much big. It was so much dark. It was completely small, and they could not move. Means they were very unable to move here and there. The five little brothers grew very gloomy. Means all five little brothers, they were very sad. Gloomy means sad. We can say sorrowful. So the five little brothers was very sad into the curious carriage. And the wee one began to pout. What is the meaning of pout? That we can say make a face. he was very sad and he began to make a face. The what we want, the very small brother, okay, that this one was begin to make face. He was making face. So till the biggest one whisper, what do you say? Let's leave the carriage and run away. So till then, the elder one brother of them, he was saying, means he was speaking very slowly, ki what are you saying? Let's leave the carriage and run away. He is saying, ki okay, let's leave that curious carriage, mein let's leave that shoes and let outside of that shoes. So out they scrambled, fight together. Means scrambled meaning we can say the run hurriedly, run very quickly. So they at the same time, because they were very frustrated in the shoes, so that is why they in a speed. What is a speed meaning? Speed. So they in a speed came out and ran quickly and they off the shoes. They left the shoes. When somebody found the carriage of leader, oh my, how she shook her head. Means there was a lady, it was a shoes of a boy, and the lady said, ki lady found that shoes and she said, toss her little boy shoes. What is the meaning of toss? Yet it was her little boy shoes, as everyone knows, as you know very well, that the poetess was compared the curious leather to the shoes. So we know very well it was the shoes of her little boy, and she claimed that ki it was the shoes of my brother, and all five little brothers were a five little toes. Means there are all five little brothers were five little toes, and they set out together for a lifelong day. So but they were feel very dull, anxious in the shoes. That is why they came out from the shoes. Okay, so everyone, in this poem we have learned about the metaphor, we have learned about the shoes, and it was compared with the curious carriage, it which was made by the leather, and it was a shoes. And there the poetess compared the five little toes, the five little brothers were the five little toes. Okay, I hope you have understood this chapter. Thank you everyone.